I read online that somebody suctioned out their IUD when they removed their menstrual cup.
Yes, you can use the menstrual cup if you have an IUD. Today's video is going to address the many misconceptions about using a menstrual cup with an IUD.
Typically, when the topic of IUDs and menstrual cups comes up, it gets pretty controversial pretty quickly. A lot of misinformation pops up with a lot of conviction, and it can be confusing and scary. We have pretty much avoided doing a video on this topic for a while because, number one, it can be controversial, and number two, we're not medical professionals. While we know from medical professionals more or less how an IUD works in relation to a cup, we want to be able to provide the best possible information that we can.
So instead of going to med school, we decided to collaborate with a medical professional. Her name is Dr. Brooke Vandermolen, and she has ensured that all the information we see today is accurate to current medical standards and the best of our collective knowledge. Before we go any further, we do recommend that if you have any concerns about using a menstrual cup with an IUD, that you talk to your care provider. Now, let's get to it. If you are unfamiliar, an IUD is a birth control method. It's a small little T-shaped device. It's placed inside the uterus and can be left in place up to 10 years. It is inserted through the cervix and placed by a medical professional, not me. Once in place, the care provider will trim the strings so that it can still be retrieved. But those strings do mean, as a menstrual cup user, that you have something that you can tug on.
This is a long-held, overcautious, and often repeated myth. You may have heard this from others who consider themselves menstrual cup experts, from ill-informed brands, and from those who are trying to capitalize on fear.
The truth is that menstrual cups do create some suction, but if you insert and remove the cup correctly, it shouldn't be enough suction to dislodge the IUD itself.
So what's really important when you're removing the cup is that you make sure that you break the seal. So when you're removing it, if you feel any kind of tugging, pulling sensation or any pain in your lower abdomen, then stop what you're doing, let go of the cup. Try again to break the seal from a different place. But if you still feel that same sensation, then stop what you're doing and seek advice from a medical professional.
The real risk of using an IUD with a cup is not the suction, but it's pulling of the strings. The strings are trimmed down by a medical professional when they place your IUD. They're typically trimmed to be about 3 centimeters long, but this can vary based on your anatomy and what they think is best. Again, if you have an IUD, you may want to inquire, or you can just reach in and feel to see how far down your strings hang. When removing a menstrual cup, we always advise to break the seal or the suction by pinching the base. But if you're someone who pinches higher, this could increase your risk of pulling your strings. Or if you're someone who has a lower cervix and the IUD and the strings are just lower inside the vaginal canal, you'll want to make sure that when you remove your cup that you are not pulling on the strings. So be aware, find your strings, and try to pinch from the very lowest part of the cup.
The other thing that can happen with and without cup usage is natural expulsion of the IUD. According to bedsider.com, natural expulsion of an IUD happens usually within the first 3 months, and it has a rate of somewhere between 0.8% and 5%. That's a pretty big range. If you are like us and you're in a group of more than 25,000 menstruators, who, many of which have an IUD, you're gonna hear a horror story from time to time. Unfortunately, this is something that can happen with an IUD, and it can have a lot of causes. Causes for natural IUD expulsion can stem from previous pregnancies, how high the IUD was placed, to unknown factors. Since the rate of natural expulsion is higher in the first 3 months, some brands do recommend that you wait until after that time period before you start using a cup again, though the research that has been done, which admittedly is very small, does not show any higher instances with cup usage.
Using a menstrual cup with an IUD in place is a very personal decision. And while we can't tell you 100% that you won't have an issue with your IUD, it's a very small risk. We really wanted to do this video to reassure you with some advice of a medical professional that the only way to expel an IUD is just because it happens naturally or because you have tugged or pulled on the strings. menstrual cup suction is not going to remove your IUD. And the chances of any of that happening are very low. So it's up to you to make that decision if using a menstrual cup with an IUD in place is something you're comfortable with and is right for you. Only you can make that call, but we just want to present that information to you so you can make it with confidence. You can talk to your care provider to get more information. You can also ask your care provider to trim the strings if that makes you more comfortable.
Thank you so much for watching, and we want to give a special thank you to Dr. Brooke Vandermolen for being here with us to discuss this very important topic. You can catch her on Instagram at @theobgynmum.
If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. And as always, we ask that you subscribe to our channel so you can be updated when we have new content. Give this video a like, and you can also join us on our Facebook group, our private troubleshooting group. We'll leave a link for that group in the description below. Thanks so much for watching. Using a menstrual cup with an IUD.
Say long hell. Long hell. Shit, that sounds right.
This conference. We're gonna adjust.
You can